Tell me about Game of Thrones. Are you enjoying being part of that?
Mate, I've met so many amazing people on the show, and filming it is so mad. Like, I've had to do, like, for this one, I had to learn to skin a rabbit. When would you ever have to do that in life? I mean, unless you're going all out and like, I'm going to go skin some rabbits today. But that's what's great about these jobs that push you to do something that maybe you wouldn't ordinarily do, like skinning 40 rabbits in a day.
What is the appeal of Game of Thrones? Why is it such a massive success?
Well, like, a lot of life is about power and power struggles. And it's kind of what we would, for me, it's a bit like how we would imagine life to have been, but with that element of magic to kind of keep us there. And, you know, it's got fantastic sex scenes and death scenes. And I like the fact anyone might die. There's no favoritism. It's much more like life that anyone at any moment might die.
We're all vulnerable and human.
Yes, exactly.
And how long do you reckon it can go on for? There's talk of it just sort of being an almost endless stream of series.
I don't know. I mean, I imagine because he's obsessed with the number 7, even though he split the two books, the three into two parts, my logical conclusion is that he'd stop at 7, but who knows?
Now, obviously, you love your character, but who else in Game of Thrones do you kind of really admire and think is an amazing person?
Gwen's character. I always get her name wrong. Brianna. What did you say, Ross?
Brienne of Tarth.
Yes. Brienne of Tarth.
Ross is a fan.
She's my favourite, definitely.
Tell me why.
Because she represents to me what a lot of women feel in a man's world, which is to be respected, you have to be 10 times better than a guy. And still, you're still treated like that, you know, and she's not your average beautiful woman. I don't know, it's the whole world of maybe being in acting as well. She calls into something in my feminist heart.